If you want a professional 3D environment design in Unreal Engine 5, you cannot ignore this. In this tutorial, I will show you how to use virtual textures, blend the material of an object with your landscape, and control its appearance with various parameters. First, from Settings, Rendering, and under Virtual Textures, enable Virtual Textures Support and restart the project to enable this compatibility. Then, in the Content Browser, make a folder for real-time virtual textures. Right-click and create two real-time virtual textures. We name them RVT Environment, which will capture the landscape material, and RVT Height, which will grab a height map for the landscape. On both of these textures, increase the texture size to 10 or higher for better resolution. Also, for the real-time texture for height, change the virtual texture content to world height. Now, at our level, let's make a runtime virtual volume under its details. Select our landscape for Bounce Align Actor and select the real-time texture we made for the environment earlier as virtual textures. Hit Set Bounds. Now, the runtime virtual volume will cover the landscape and it will capture its texture to our virtual texture map. Let's make another runtime virtual volume in our level and do the same process for the real-time virtual texture for the height map. Now we have our setup, we need to capture the virtual texture information from our landscape materials. In this case, we use one of the Quixel Megascans library materials. Let's bring in a material attribute and extract the base color, specular, roughness, and normal from its details. Bring a runtime virtual texture output and connect the base color, specular, and roughness. To connect the normal, we have to change the normal from tangent space to world space. We bring a world position and use its Z amount for the world height of the runtime virtual texture. Now save everything and go back to our level. Select our landscape's detail. In our landscape detail, under virtual texture, we create two elements to draw in virtual texture and assign them with the virtual texture we made for environment and height. If you see these two thumbnails, you are on the right track. Now, we have to adjust the material on the object to blend with the landscape. We use another Quixel bridge material and object here as well. Let's go to its master material. We are going to blend the original material with the texture that we captured with virtual texture and blend them with an alpha that captures the intersection of the object and landscape. Make sure that your material shading model is set to default lit. Now, let's make the alpha first. We are starting with a world position and a runtime virtual texture and selecting the height map that we made before. We subtract the world height from the world position to get the areas where the object and landscape intersect. We divide it with a scalar parameter to control its hardness. Also, we use a saturate node to clamp everything to 0 to 1. This is our alpha. Let's take a look at it before we bring our virtual texture. We use a color set for the material attribute and assign it to A. As you can see, it works at our level and we have control over its hardness with the parameters we set. Let's bring the final material in. We make a runtime virtual texture and under its detail, we select the virtual texture we made for the environment. We use a set of material attributes to set the base color, specular, roughness, and normal. Connect everything. We change the normal map from world space to tangent space, which is the standard format for normals in any material. After connecting it to our blend, you can see the results at our level. Let's make more variables for the blending section. I want to increase or decrease the area of the intersection. In other words, have a fall off for it. Let's disconnect it for a second. I use an object bound and the blue channel, which in this case shows the object's height. We add the object's height to the area of the intersection we achieved before and subtract a multiple of the object's height so that we can increase or decrease the intersection area with a scalar parameter. It is a bit mind-boggling, but think about it briefly, or copy from here. Now, we have more control over the blend. Everything seems good, but on the vertical parts of our object, the texture appears stretched out. We have modified the alpha to remove these parts. We use a vertex normal node and a mask to isolate the blue channel, which indicates the z-axis. We multiply it by a scalar parameter named side remover. This parameter helps us mask the vertical parts of our material. Then, we use a saturate node to clamp everything between 0 and 1, and multiply these nodes by the inverse of the alpha we had because we want to remove these parts. Then we invert the result again to obtain the final alpha result and connect it to the alpha channel. Now we have total control over blending with various parameters. Now we want a better material setup by placing everything in a material function and using that function wherever we want. First, we should change the two virtual texture samples with virtual texture sample parameters and set each one to its proper setting, as mentioned earlier. Then we create a material function, cut everything we built, and paste it into the material function. Connect the output of the material blend node to the output node and create an input node, setting its type to function input material attribute and connecting it to input B of the material blend node. Now we can call our new function in the main material and connect it to the right nodes. What if we want to avoid blending on some objects that use this parent material? Let's make a switch in our material function so we can toggle between the object's original material and the one we made by adding virtual texture. Now we can control whether we want to blend an object with landscape material. Please like and subscribe for more educational content.